Today in this class we shall see the Newton's formula for velocity of sound and Laplace's correction. We have already found out the velocity of a longitudinal wave in a gaseous medium. Velocity B is equal to under root E by rho, where E is the volume or bulk modulus of elasticity of the medium. And rho is the density of the medium. Also, it was explained that the longitudinal wave moves in a medium by having compressions and rarefactions. Sound is one of the commonest example of a longitudinal wave. Now, according to Newton, when the sound moves in a gaseous medium, suppose in air, so obviously there will be compressions and there will be rarefactions at different points. Newton assumed that, he thought that this process of propagation of sound in air is a very slow process, and as such, at places where there were compressions, it will be generated, and at places where there were rarefactions, there will be a cooling effect. So, from those places where there were compressions, heat will be generated, and the heat will be absorbed by the body of the gas, and at those places where there were rarefactions, cooling effect will be there, and so the heat will be absorbed by those rarefaction positions from the body of the gas. As such, what will happen? There will be exchange of heat in the gaseous medium. So the process will be isothermal, that is, as the process is slow and the heat is being exchanged, the process will be isothermal, that is, the temperature of this whole process will remain constant. That was what was assumed by Newton. So Newton assumed that propagation of sound through air or a gaseous medium was an isothermal process. And for an isothermal process, the ideal gas equation is given by PB equal to constant, where P is the pressure and V is the volume. Now, if you differentiate this equation, we have P dV plus V dP equal to 0, or P equal to minus V dP by dV, and we can write it as minus dP by dV by V. So this is stress and this is strain. And this is the E, or the volume modulus. Volume or bulk modulus of elasticity. Now, in this equation for the velocity of longitudinal wave, we can write in place of E, P. So let us do it. Therefore, the velocity of sound is equal to, in a gaseous medium, is equal to under root P by rho. In place of the bulk modulus E, we get P. Now at STP, that is at standard temperature, and pressure, STP, in STP the temperature is 0 degree centigrade or 273 Kelvin. P is equal to 760 millimeter of mercury or 1 atmosphere. Now pressure is given by H rho G, or we have already used rho, so let us write it as H dG, pressure at STP, H dG, where H is the height of the mercury column, D is the density of mercury, and G is the acceleration due to gravity. H is 760 millimeter or 76 centimeter. D, that is the density of mercury, is almost equal to 13.6 gram per centimeter cube, and G, acceleration due to gravity, we take it as 980 centimeter per second square. Also, the density of air at STP rho is equal to 0.001293 gram per centimeter cube. So putting this value in this above equation, we get V equal to under root 76 centimeter into 13.6 gram per centimeter cube into 980 centimeter per second square by 0.001293 gram per centimeter cube. And if we calculate, this comes out to be almost 28000 centimeter per second, and this is equal to 280 meter per second. So if we use Newton's formula, then the velocity of sound comes out to be 280 meter per second. But at STP, if the velocity of sound is calculated experimentally, then velocity of sound in air is at this STP is given or is found out experimentally as equal to 332 meter per second. So you can see there is some difference, and this velocity is much lower than the actual or the experimental value of the velocity of sound in air at STP. So as this result, which was found out by Newton's formula, gave the velocity of sound, which is almost having error of 16%. So this error couldn't be attributed to some sort of experimental error. So it was thought that there is some inherent correction which is to be done in this formula given by Newton for the velocity of sound. So after a century later, Laplace, he corrected this Newton's formula for the velocity of sound. So now we see the Laplace's correction. Now what Laplace pointed out was that this process of propagation of sound in air or in any gaseous medium was a very fast process, and the compression and rarefactions were taking place very fast. And as already mentioned, at the places where there were compressions, heat will be generated, and at the places where there will be rarefactions, there will be some cooling effect. And so as the process was very fast, the places where the heat was generated, the time was not there for this heat to be dissipated or to be absorbed by the body of the gas. And also at the places where there were rarefactions, there were cooling effects. And so at these places, the heat couldn't be absorbed from the body of the gas. As such, in this process, there was no exchange of heat taking place. In other words, the process was an adiabatic process. So, Laplace pointed out that this process was an adiabatic process. That is, heat remained constant. And for the ideal gas equation in which heat remains constant is PB to the power gamma is constant. This is the gas equation where gamma is the Cp by Cv, that is the ratio of specific heat at constant pressure to the constant volume, specific heat at constant volume. This is specific heat at constant pressure by specific heat at constant volume. And so let us differentiate this equation, and this is gamma is a constant depending upon if the gas is monatomic, diatomic or triatomic. Now if we differentiate this equation PV to the power gamma, we have this equation PV to the power gamma is equal to constant. If we differentiate it, this is gamma P V gamma minus 1 dV plus dP and V to the power gamma is equal to 0. And if we divide it by V to the power gamma, the whole equation we have gamma P by V dV plus dP equal to 0. Or gamma P equal to minus dP by dV by V. Therefore, this we can write it again as equal to E, that is the volume modulus of elasticity or the bulk modulus. Therefore, the velocity of sound is given by this formula. V will be equal to E by rho, and now this is gamma P by rho. And in Newton's formula, it was P by rho, and so this is the Laplace's correction. Now, if we want to find the value of the velocity of sound using this formula, then we'll find it like this. For air, gamma is 1.41. Air consists of primarily nitrogen, and that's diatomic, so we take gamma equal to 1.41 in this case. Rest remains same. So V is equal to under root 1.41 into P, that is 76 centimeter, into 13.6 gram per centimeter cube, into 980 centimeter per second square by rho, that is 0.001293 gram per centimeter cube. And if we calculate it, then it comes almost to be equal to 332.35 centimeter per second, and that is equal to 332.35 meter per second. And this value of velocity of sound as calculated from Laplace's correction or Laplace's formula is very close to the actual experimental value, equal to 332 meter per second. So this value was almost equal to the value, actual value calculated, and we can say that whatever Laplace's made, this correction was very apt. So Newton's formula, is a velocity of sound is p by rho and Laplace's correction is equal to gamma p by rho for the velocity of sound, where gamma is the ratio of specific heat at constant pressure to the specific heat at constant volume, Cp by C. So that's all for